Turns out, there's more than just dietary reasons to hate McDonald's.
McDonald's
just found a way to save you, me, and all our owner-operators literally hundreds of dollars a year in electrical
And what
costs.
Would that be?
Two words, powdered milkshake. I'm telling you, I came across
a remarkable product called Instamix. Like I say, it's a powdered milkshake. It's a fraction of the cost of ice cream and requires no refrigeration.
Ray.
I tell you, I tried it myself. It tastes just like the real thing.
It's delicious. It comes in chocolate, comes in vanilla. Me, I'm a vanilla man.
Ray, we have no interest in a milkshake that contains no milk. Why don't we add sawdust to the hamburgers while we're at it? Frozen French fries.
You don't want to save a bundle.
Not like that.
We're talking about
the same great taste. Same great taste while boosting the bottom line.
It's called a milkshake, Ray.
Real milk.
Now and forever.
The Founder stars Michael Keaton in the true story of Ray Kroc, also known as the founder of fast food juggernaut McDonald's. But there's a little more to the story that you haven't heard. Is there enough nutritional value in this meal for you to enjoy it? Well, here's five things about the founder. Yeah, I think this makes a good meal with maybe a little bit of a bad aftertaste. We'll talk about that later. Let's start here. I can't believe how brutal this movie is. This just lays into Ray Kroc and McDonald's, and you're not going to like this guy by the end. And I'm guessing they have the truth on their side to be able to say these things. Otherwise, I imagine McDonald's and the family of Ray Kroc would be suing them for painting him this way. But it is a brutal telling of what this man did. And I think even because of that, it really elevates the movie to a more interesting place for me. And part of the reason it works, I think, comes down to Michael Keaton. He's phenomenal here. I think this is his best performance of all time. Better than Birdman, better than Spotlight, better than the old stuff, better than Multiplicity. I'm just telling you, this is a great performance because he adds nuance to this business jerk. And he gives you a sense of why this man acted this way. Even though it's deplorable, it's still interesting to see this was a real human being. That's not actually easy to pull off, but he does it here, and I think it serves the movie very well. I also really like that it's quick and witty, and there's some humor here. A lot of biopics tend to get dragged down into their own sense of importance and drama, and even though there's really interesting stuff about this true story, this movie does a great job at keeping it moving. I really enjoyed the pace of this, and it keeps you in it in a way that I don't think it would if it slowed it down. So what about possible negatives? Well, let's start with a warning first. You're going to leave angry, and it's not a fun thing to do. I talked about, you know, kind of the bad taste in your mouth afterwards. I came out of this very, very upset with McDonald's. But I think that's good. Now, for some, you may not enjoy that. You want to leave with a little bit of optimism, a little bit of hop in your step. I get it, but I think it's important because it's founded, excuse the pun, in truth. And so I think it's justified to be angry when you leave something like this. There's really not a lot here to dislike for me. If I had to pull something out, I did think some of the side performances were a little bit stale. Now, that could be just that Keaton is giving such a great performance that how they compare to him, they're just not quite living up to what he's doing. But I did find myself looking at some of these surrounding players and saying, not quite up to snuff. Overall, though, The Founder is a really interesting, really entertaining, and really important look at the fast food giant McDonald's and the person behind making them what they are. I give it a very solid A-. Thanks for checking out this Your Movie Friend review. We'll get to the best ever challenge here in a bit. Before we do, if you want to connect further, I'd love that. Certainly subscribe and follow here on YouTube. Leave comments. That's always fun. You can also follow on Twitter. I would love that. We can chat movies there. Aaron Dicer, A-A-R-O-N-D-I-C-E-R. And if you want to listen to the podcast, SiftPop, S-I-F-T-P-O-P is the name of the podcast. We get together every week and talk pop culture and other things. We ranked all the M. Night Shyamalan movies this week. The official Sift Sort SiftPop list. So you can check that out on the podcast this week. And that's a great way to follow along, too. All right, on to the Best Ever Challenge, where you name the best movie ever in a particular category and also try to identify my choice. Let's go with the best ever Michael Keaton movie. Now, he's been in quite a few and quite a few good ones. For me, I just say that Michael Keaton, he's such a doll, isn't he? Just such a doll. You can take a guess at mine based on that clue in the comments. Don't forget to leave your choice there as well. By the way, if you get it right first, you do get a point. As always, I'll give you 5 extra seconds here to hit the subscribe logo to subscribe to this YouTube channel. Pop it right down here in this corner. 5 seconds is happening now. You click down there.